Hi, this is MC Zetti, and in this short video I'm going to demonstrate a new feature in XNet, which is the ability to copy channels and connectors to the clipboard. So say you have a setup. This is a setup where you have an input chest with coal and iron ore and an output chest for iron ingots. And there's this channel, so you have input for iron so this is the output chest, and it has insert for iron ore, for iron ingots I mean, and that's the input chest where it will extract these two. There's the furnace. The furnace is sided, so that's important. From below, we extract from north. We actually have an advanced connector here because. See, we don't actually have any connection on the upper side, and same here. So we have to use advanced connectors in some places to be able to do this, because an advanced connector can extract from a different side than the one that is actually connected. So say you have this setup. Let's enable it to see it in action. So it takes a while before the round robin actually works. Yeah, so now it's doing things. It's just a simple setup. Nothing special. Like this. Let's disable it. Let's also remove these. So that when we copy, the names of these will be... because this is actually lit furnace now. And I need it to be furnace before copying, because that's important. It will probably work as well, but anyway, let me show you. So here I have a similar setup. It's empty, and the connectors are different. For example, there are no advanced connectors, but all connectors are already at the correct site. So will it be able to match this setup to that one? We will see. Once these are done, you know what, let me just break these, that's easier. So okay, so there are two new buttons here, copy this connector and copy this channel. Copy this connector is for an individual connector, but we want to copy the entire channel now. So it's now to the system clipboard, which means that you can actually paste it in a text editor or share it with someone else. But in this case, we are going to paste it here. So it moved over the information. So because this connector is named output and this connector is named input, it managed to do. It will put the right data with the right connector, and it also preserved its. Was able to see that these should be the extract because it's down, even though they are not advanced connectors. A paste will fail if, say for example, you used... no, that's not an advanced. This is an advanced. Say you... but this is a bad example. Say you had an extract node with that was advanced and that used a setting which is not supported for non-advanced, then the paste would have failed. But in this case it worked, and if we now enable this, yeah, it's busy, and it should at a while at some time start kicking off. Yeah, now it's busy. And so it's working. To demonstrate what will happen, if say for example, so let's remove this channel. Say this furnace isn't there, and you wanted to paste it. Actually, that's a bug. Okay, I will fix that. But it should give a warning that it wasn't able to paste everything. But it will paste as much as possible. So, but I will fix that the warning is still there. When pasting, a channel will always start disabled. This is to make sure that you can first evaluate everything that is that was needed. So this is the new feature. I'm going to work on a few of the bugs, make it stable and foolproof, and then it will be in a new version. XNet coming to you soon. See you next time. Bye bye.